Welcome to Speak English Now podcast with your host, Georgiana, the podcast that will help you to speak English fluently with no grammar and no textbooks.
Hi, dear listener. I'm Georgiana, founder of the Speak English Now podcast. My mission is to help you to speak English fluently. Speaking English is way easier when you use the right material and techniques. In this episode, we continue learning more vocabulary related to school supplies. And with an exclusive point of view story, you'll learn grammar without memorizing any boring rules. Remember, you can get the text of this episode at speakenglishpodcast.com. Okay, let's continue. If you love this podcast, please share it with your friends and family. That would make me very happy. The show is available everywhere on the internet. If you want to read the transcript while listening, follow the show on my website, speakenglishpodcast.com. However, you can also find the podcast on different apps like Spotify, iTunes, YouTube, Facebook, SoundCloud, etc. Just look for Speak English Now with Georgiana and start learning English with me. Okay, let's start today's lesson by going over the vocabulary used last week in episode 104. In the previous episode, we talked about going back to school, focusing on the necessary material. We learned some new words. Let's listen to them one more time. Notebook, clips, paper sheets, pens, pencils, eraser, felt tips, markers, and ruler. Now it's time to learn new vocabulary. Let's start. Agenda, which I think is the most crucial element for a student. An agenda contains the days of the year and the holidays. So the student can write down the dates of exams, activities, etc. In this way, in theory, everything is under control. I say this in theory because many times kids forget to write things down and it's a chaos. I remember when I was little, I was a bit absent-minded and rarely wrote anything down. I once lost my agenda and I still don't know how I passed the different courses. Let's continue with textbooks. One disadvantage of textbooks is that they're really heavy. This is something I didn't like when I was in school, although I love the way textbooks used to smell when they were new. Next word is scissors. Sooner or later, every student needs to cut a piece of paper or something else. We do not use knives or axes or laser swords like a Jedi. That would be inefficient and dangerous. That's why we use scissors in the classroom. They are useful and safer than a sword. Let's continue with glue. Scissors can be used to divide a paper in two, while glue can be used to stick two sheets of paper, for instance. There are different types of glue. For example, the glue stick is quite popular. Simply remove the lid and apply the stick where you want to add glue. Other glue formats are equally effective. Pay attention to the type of glue you buy, because it wouldn't be the first time a child sticks his fingers together and then can't pull them apart. Make sure you purchase paper glue. Next word, transparent adhesive tape roll. This transparent tape has many uses. So if you don't want to use the glue, it's a great alternative. Next word is folder. A folder is essential for organizing sheets, notes, etc. I had one with dividers. So in theory, I had all my papers organized. Although, I usually put some sheets in the wrong place in the folder. In the end, I spent a lot of time looking for those sheets. Let's continue with the word case. So, where do we put all the pens, pencils, erasers, and markers? In a plastic bag? No. That's not very elegant, and it's quite impractical. So it's best to use a case. It's a kind of cover where you can store your school stuff. Obviously, they come in different types of materials and colors. Let's continue with backpack. And where do we keep the case? Well, the case, the notebook, the textbooks, the folder, and the sandwich. Don't forget your lunch. That's the most important thing. You need a good backpack or rucksack to carry all that. Next word is stapler. If you don't like clips, you can use a stapler to staple your notes or whatever you want. A stapler without staples is useless though, so you need to put staples in a stapler. Also, just in case, a staple remover, which is a small tool that allows you to remove the staples. Wow, you must be really confused by now, because I use the word stapler, staple, staples, and staple remover. You see, that's why I always tell you to learn English in context. So, just listen to this lesson until you get the hang of the different meanings. Well, I think that's enough for now. I'm sure there are other school materials I haven't mentioned, but I think it's a great selection of vocabulary. Remember that the most effective way to learn vocabulary is to see it in context. Cool! Let's continue with the point of view story. You will learn to improve your English grammar without memorizing any rules. I'm going to tell the same story 3 times. So pay attention to the different grammar points. It is a technique that I use in my courses. You just have to listen and enjoy the story. We'll start in the 3rd person. A mother wakes her son in the morning, telling him that he has to get up to go to school. The son replies that he doesn't want to go and that he wants to stay at home. His mother, angry, asks him why he doesn't want to go. The son responds by giving 3 reasons. The 1st reason is that he's very sleepy. The 2nd reason is that he gets bored in school. And the 3rd reason is that the children laugh at him. The mother, looking at her son perplexed, gives him 3 other reasons to go to school. The 1st reason, it's his obligation, even if he doesn't like it. The 2nd reason, he's 40 years old. The 3rd reason, he's the school principal. Now, let's listen from the mother's point of view. I wake up my son in the morning and tell him he has to get up to go to school. My son replies that he doesn't want to go and that he wants to stay at home. Angry, I ask him why he doesn't want to go. My son responds by giving me 3 reasons. The 1st reason is that he's very sleepy. The 2nd reason he gives me is that he gets bored at school. And the 3rd reason is that the kids laugh at him. Looking at my son perplexed, I give him 3 other reasons to go to school. The 1st reason? It's his obligation, even if he doesn't like it. The 2nd reason, he's already 40 years old. The 3rd reason, he's the school principal. Finally, we'll listen to the story from the son's point of view. My mother wakes me up in the morning and tells me that I have to get up and go to school. I reply that I don't want to go and that I want to stay at home. My mother, angry, asks me why I don't want to go. I respond giving three reasons. The first reason is that I'm very sleepy. The second reason I give her is that I get bored at school. And the third reason is that the kids laugh at me. My mother, looking at me perplexed, gives me three other reasons to go to school. The first reason is that it's my obligation, even if I don't like it. The second reason, I'm 40 years old. The third reason, I'm the school principal. Maybe I have to pay more attention to my mother. This is the end of this point of view. What a funny story. Sometimes we can relate to the man from the story. It's not always easy being an adult. When we were children, we could still make excuses. And sometimes we evaded our responsibilities. But as adults, we ought to be more responsible for setting an example for our children or students. Today has been an interesting exercise because you have seen these small changes between grammar points of view. They are subtle changes that are almost impossible to memorize with grammatical rules. You have to listen to them many times and in different contexts. Okay, have you seen the power of the point of view technique? We have checked a lot of grammar by merely using the same story. It's very easy to compare the different structures because you compare in parallel. If you want to get hours of audio with mini stories and point of view lessons, I'd like to recommend to you my fluency course. You can get it at fluency.speakenglishpodcast.com. Well, that's it for today. I'll be back next week with a new episode. Take care. Bye-bye.
Did you enjoy today's episode? Get the transcript now at speakenglishpodcast.com. speakenglishpodcast.com.